There's nothing to be hoped for from the elector at present. The day before yesterday, I went to the concert at court to get his answer. Count Savioli studiously avoided me, but I made my way up to him, and when he saw me, he shrugged his shoulders. What? I said, no answer yet. Please forgive me, he replied. Unfortunately, none. Well, I said, the elector might have told me so before. True, he said, but he wouldn't have made up his mind even now if I hadn't prodded him and pointed out that you've been hanging on here for such a long time and were using up all your money at the inn. Yes, that's what worries me most of all, I retorted. It's not at all nice. However, I am very much obliged to you, Count. We don't address him as Your Excellency. For having taken such an interest in me, and I beg you to thank the elector on my behalf for his gracious, though belated, reply, and to say that I can assure him that he would never have regretted it if he'd taken me on. Next Wednesday, I'm going to Kirchheim-Belanden for a few days to visit the Princess of Orange. People here have said such nice things to me about her that I've at last decided to go. I've had 4 arias copied for her, and as she has a nice little orchestra and gives a concert every day, I shall also present her with a symphony. Moreover, the copying of the arias will not cost me much, for it's been done by a certain Herr Weber, who is accompanying me there. I don't know whether or not I've already written about his daughter. She sings indeed most admirably and has a lovely, pure voice. The only thing she lacks is dramatic action, were it not for that. She might be the prima donna on any stage. She's only 16. What is most fortunate for her at Mannheim is that she has won the praise of all honest people of goodwill, even the elector and the electress are only too glad to receive her, provided it doesn't cost it. On Saturday evening, we went to court, where Mademoiselle Weber sang 3 arias. I say nothing about her singing, only one word, excellent. We again had a concert on Monday, and also on Tuesday and Wednesday. Mademoiselle Weber sang 13 times in all, and played the clavier twice. She doesn't play at all badly. Would you believe it? She played my difficult sonatas at sight, slowly, but without missing a single note. I played 12 times in all, and once by request on the organ in the Lutheran church. I presented 4 symphonies to the princess and received only 7 louis d'or in silver, and poor Mademoiselle Weber only 5. Really, it was the last thing I expected. I've become so fond of this unfortunate family that my dearest wish is to make them happy, and perhaps I may be able to do so. My advice is that they should go to Italy. So now I should like you to write to our good friend Luggiati, and the sooner the better, and inquire what are the highest terms given to a prima donna in Verona. The more, the better. One can always climb down. You know, my greatest desire is to write operas. I would gladly write an opera for Verona for 50 zecchini, if only that she may make her name. By that time, I shall have made so much money on the other journeys we propose to undertake together that I shan't be the loser. And the thought of helping a poor family without injury to myself delights my very soul. I could not get on at all without pupils, which is a kind of work that is quite uncongenial to me. I would gladly give lessons as a favour, particularly when I see that my pupil has talent, inclination, and anxiety to learn, but to be obliged to go to a house at a certain hour or have to wait at home for a pupil is what I cannot do, no matter how much money it may bring me. I am a composer and was born to be a Kapellmeister. I neither can nor ought to bury the talent for composition with which God, in his goodness, has so richly endowed me. I may say so with conceit, for I feel it now more than ever. I brought along the new symphony which I have just finished and with which the concert spirituel will open at Corpus Christi. They both liked it very much, and I too am quite pleased with it, but I can't say whether it'll be popular. To tell the truth, I don't care very much, for who will not like it? I can answer for its pleasing the few intelligent French people who may be there, and as for the stupid ones, I shan't consider it a great misfortune if they're not pleased. I still hope, however, that even asses will find something in it to admire.